The new California rule, in both its stringency and its reach, could stand alongside the Washington laws. It's going to be even more effective. Why? Because California is such a large market, and because there's 12 other states that will potentially adopt the new California emissions standard. I pointed that out last week. And now Washington State has already done it. Washington State said, we're in. And in Virginia, you have Youngkin, the governor there, says, well, you had my predecessor there, the the blackface Democrat, he signed us on to, Ralph Northam, signed us on to follow whatever California does. And so if the if CARB, the California Air, what does it stand for? The California Air Resources Board, CARB. He wants to put Virginia on a no-carb diet. Let's talk about what is happening with this, because in Washington State, immediately Governor Inslee, who also has presidential aspirations, just like Newsom, made the announcement on Twitter, because now we have dictators who dictate on Twitter. If only Adolf Hitler had had Twitter, right? We have now annexed the Sudetenland, right? The Anschluss with Austria. It's ours. I just said so. It's on Twitter. So, I have Jay Inslee noting that by the end of the year, Washington State will adopt California's laws requiring 35% of new cars sold in the state to be electric or plug-in hybrids by 2026, 68% by 2030, and 100% by 2035. The Washington State of Ecology will handle the rulemaking process. You see that? That's what the governor says. So this is what we're going to do, says the governor, and I'm going to use the bureaucracy to do it. Do you understand how the laws are made now? Forget about Schoolhouse Rock. I'm a bill. And a bill has been killed. all the bills have been killed. No, that's dictates from executives, and it's regulations from the bureaucracy that is under the executive, you see. So you have the Department of Ecology will handle the rulemaking process. They will be rules that will come from them. What do we call the people who make the rules? Rulers. Who is the bureaucracy? The people who make the rules. The bureaucracy. This is bureaucratic rule. We're being ruled by bureaucrats. This is regulation without representation, folks. It's also taxation without representation. And this is a big problem in all these different areas. It's not just the environmental stuff. It's everywhere. All of this stuff is being done this way. Years ago, Rand Paul used to focus on that. He would put out the RAINS Act. He understands what the problem is, but now, he's got other fish to fry. But here's the key thing. 10 months ago, before Newsom, before Inslee, before any of this stuff, it was automakers who were taking the lead. 6 major automakers pledged to stop selling gas and diesel-powered cars worldwide by 2040. I reported on it at the time, it was last November, and I'd forgotten about that until I saw that in this article. So here are the companies. Ford, GM, Volvo, so that's the big three right there because Volvo owns Chrysler now, I believe. Stellantis, I think, is owned by... Stellantis owned by... Look that up, Travis, and... because otherwise people have to write me emails if I got that wrong. But basically, Chrysler's foreign owned, I think by Volvo via Stellantis. But anyway, Ford and GM and Mercedes-Benz and Jaguar Land Rover all signed on in November, last November, at the UN Climate Change Conference. See where it's coming from? The purpose of the UN is to build consensus and to pull the companies and the countries together, but especially Davos, because you have to have an executive who's doing this stuff. And Davos is, for the most part, matching up the corporations and the billionaires, but sometimes they just go directly to the UN. But it is a partnership between the UN and Davos. And so at the November UN Climate Change Conference, 30 countries and 6 major automobile companies and 24 No, Chrysler, no, they were owned by Fiat. And then look up Stellantis, see who owns Stellantis. Fiat sold them. 24 fleet operators, including Uber, all signed on to this. And the agreement includes discontinuing all sales in leading markets by 2035. So, sorry, Newsom. Sorry, Inslee. You've been outflanked by the UN-loving corporations that are focused on ESG. Sustainable Development Goals, SDG. ESG, SDG. And so you're not going to be able to buy a car because these people aren't going to make them. They're only going to make battery EVs. Yeah, they're Stellantis. And so who owns Stellantis? Is that, that's the question. You notice what's missing on here. You know, we have the usual suspects in, from Davos, the governments of Canada, Britain, other European countries like France, Spain, Denmark, Netherlands have all set goals for phasing out the sale of gasoline-powered vehicles, right? But when you look at the corporations, they're the ones that are really going to make this stuff work, because if they don't make the cars, who's who are you going to get them from? And you know who's not on that list? No Japanese companies. Toyota, largest automobile manufacturer, is not there. No Chinese companies. No South Korean car companies. Hyundai's not there. Toyota's not there. Nissan, Mazda, not there. Isn't that interesting? Because this is all political, you understand. And I think it's also interesting that Hyundai and Toyota would still be working on things other than just an electric battery car. They may wind up with the whole shebang, because they may wind up with the only thing that people can get fuel for. Because if you're limited to the to charging it over the grid, then you're out of luck. And if they can find some way to do an electric vehicle that uses hydrogen, and there's a lot of technical issues with it, as well as infrastructure issues as well. But if they can find some way to do it, it may be the only game in town, because they're going to shut down the production of fuel as well. That's what we're already in the process of. So you have the government's usual suspects are all saying they're going to phase this stuff out 2030 to 2040. So that brings us back to Glenn Youngkin, who says he's going to get off of this. He said, in an effort to turn Virginia into California, liberal politicians who previously ran our government sold Virginia out by subjecting Virginia drivers to California vehicle laws, Youngkin wrote on a statement on Twitter. That's where they all go to talk anymore. Now, under that pact, Virginians will be forced to adopt the California law that prohibits the sale of gas and diesel-fueled vehicles. I'm already at work to prevent this ridiculous edict, that's what it is, from being forced on Virginians. California's out-of-touch laws have no place on our Commonwealth. Well, you know, EV owners were left shocked after China began shutting down charging stations. And this isn't from this particular incident, but this is a large line already, once before, of cars in China, EV cars, trying to get charged. Here's the EV MacGuffin and what it looks like when you're trying to get a charge. Boy, look at that line. Round and round and round they go. Now, worse than the gas lines of the 1970s. Still going. Aerial view. So, EV owners in China, as I reported last week briefly, because why is this happening? It's interesting. You know, the Tesla had its... they announced a rollback, a significant rollback of charging stations being shut down because they were told to by the government. And then one of their competitors, NIO, or NIO, I don't know how you pronounce it, N-I-O, that company is the one that offered the battery swapping. So you drive your car up, you know, they lift it up on a jack and they pull the dead battery out or the low battery and they put a freshly charged, fully charged battery in, and you're on your way. That's the fastest way that they could do it. Still probably slower than filling up with your gasoline, I time myself and just the pumping part of it to fill my little 10-gallon tank on my car. Only takes me 30 seconds. So typically, some pumps are faster, some are slower. I don't think they could swap that thing out in 30 seconds, but they have battery swapping stations. And so the government told them to shut down as well. You're not going to be able to charge the stuff there. So the why is this happening? Because, you know, China, why is China having problems with this and telling them you got to shut down the charging stations? Well, they don't have enough power on the grid. But why don't they have enough power on the grid? See, China is not shutting down their fossil fuel generation. China is building massive numbers of fossil fuel companies. They are building new refineries, unlike us. You know, they last year, they kicked off on a multi-billion dollar refinery. We haven't built one in decades. And as one CEO of Chevron said, I don't think the U.S. will ever build another oil refinery. But they're building them in China, so I guess we can go get our stuff from China. That'll be great. Just as all the people who were pushing globalism in the lifting up stage, you know, back in the 90s, all the libertarian think tanks and Reason magazine would say, you don't want to have any manufacturing in America. You can get it from China. They got slave labor anyway. You don't want to do that kind of dirty, dangerous work. And so now I guess the same thing is true. The air is going to be really dirty in China, but who cares? You know, we're not talking about global climate change, are we? Oh, yeah, we are. So why doesn't it matter when it's dirty power plants in India and China? Some environmentalists who actually believe in the climate MacGuffin are actually upset about that. And they see the climate, Paris Climate Accord as a scam. They see it as only about shifting money and power around. The common man. They created Common Core to dumb down our children. They created Common Pass to track and control us. Their Commons Project to make sure the commoners own nothing. And the communist future. They see the common man as simple, unsophisticated, ordinary. But each of us has worth and dignity created in the image of God. That is what we have in common. That is what they want to take away. Their most powerful weapons are isolation, deception, intimidation. They desire to know everything about us while they hide everything from us. It's time to turn that around and expose what they want to hide. Please share the information and links you'll find at thedavidknightshow.com. Thank you for listening. Thank you for sharing. If you can't support us financially, please keep us in your prayers. TheDavidKnightShow.com.